How you doing? This is Vaughn Edmead from AverageIsFailure.com, and I want to talk to you guys about today about the right having the right information, right? And the way I phrase it is that right choices require right information. Right choices require the right information. And you should probably write that down somewhere, because what you have to understand is that most of the time we make decisions based on the information that we have. And so I want to use a spiritual story in order to paint the picture, because that's kind of where this idea came from. So even if you're not spiritual, even if you're not Christian, pay attention to the principle that I'm sharing, okay? Pay attention to the principle that I'm sharing. So in the Bible, there's this story about a woman who has an issue of blood. And she's been sick with this issue for 12 years. And what it says is that because of this issue, what she felt based on the information that she had, she goes to different doctors and physicians in order to find a solution, in order to find healing. And instead of bringing healing, it says that she actually grew worse when she went to them, and that they took advantage of her, right? So you have this situation where, based on the information that she had, thinking that it would solve the problem, it just added on to the problem. And then the story goes on to say that she hears about Jesus. And when she hears about Jesus, she goes ahead, she takes action, and eventually she goes, finds him, touches the hem of his garment, and she's healed, right? Now, the story goes a lot deeper than that, but that's, you know, we're not talking about that all the rest of that today, right? But we're talking about her having the right information in order to make a good decision, which leads to her ability to get healed. And one of the reasons, because all of us have had instances in our life, and some of us might be going through certain things right now, and we might be acting or conducting ourselves, behaving in a particular way based on the information that we have so far, not understanding that that information that we have, if we don't have the right information, if we're not privy to, and if we don't have access to the right information, then we can't make the right decisions. And the reason why having the right information is so important is because the right information is what allows you to know and see what the possibilities are that you've been looking for. Without the right information, you don't know what the possibilities are there. And if you don't know what the possibilities are, it's hard for you to find a solution to the problem that you're having, right? Because you don't know that it's out there. So one of the things that I think about, and I refer to this all the time, especially for the Black community, is that when you're dealing with situations, for instance, in the hood, one of the problems that you have in the hood is that people don't have we'll call it exposure, right? A lot of people may not be exposed to the right information. So in certain communities like where I work, I lived in it for a while. When I was born, Brooklyn, Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, right? So I mean, it's getting better now, but back in the day, you all already know if you're from New York. So one of the things that happens is that if you're not exposed to the right information, then the possibilities seem limited. So when you're in a situation where success looks like it's only framed by drug dealers and dope boys, maybe stripping, when success looks like it's being a basketball player or a football player or being a rapper, then what happens is that because it's not like anybody's walking around saying that I don't want to be successful, right? But what's happening is that their definition of success is determined by what they've been exposed to. So that's why it's important for those who do know that there are better ways to say, listen, okay, I have to take you and expose you to the right information so that you can see that there are other possibilities, so that you can see that it's possible for you to be a lawyer. It's possible for you to be a doctor. It's possible for you to be some sort of physician. It's possible for you to be a judge. It's possible for you to be a police officer. It's possible for you to be an author. Possible for you to be a motivational speaker. The reason why I began doing what I'm doing now is because luckily I had people in my life who had exposed me. My father exposed me from when I was in high school to motivational speakers, and had me reading books by like men like Robert Kiyosaki or what have you. I was blessed to be to be around Eric Thomas. I've been like my mom and my father and the people around me allowed me to be exposed to different things so that I knew what the possibilities were out there, right? So, and it's especially important because when you find hiccups, like I had some hiccups in my life, but I knew what the possibilities were, and it made it easier for me to get back on track because I had the right information. So here's how you, and I want to do this quickly, here's how you get the right information, all right? One of the easiest ways, because some of y'all, I know some of y'all ain't into reading books, right? But one of the best ways to get to the right information is simply go on YouTube, right? Most of my videos are on YouTube. So go search other, there are TEDx conferences. Find the thought leaders on subjects that you're interested in, right? So that you can become exposed to the right information. If you're trying to start a business, go find videos on YouTube about starting a business. Don't just, right? Because some people think that it's good to just have a product, right? That's my product, my book. I have some shirts and all that kind of stuff coming out too, right? But what I had to understand is that it's not just about having the book. The book is good. But the information that I didn't have at first was understanding that writing a book is very different than selling a book. That's why Robert Kiyosaki says all the time, it's one thing, it never says best written book, right? It always says best selling book. And so it's what you need to do is figure out what information do I need to sell a book properly. So watch YouTube videos, find books on those same subject matters also. Take the time to read. Please take the time to read. It's very important. Reading changed my life. In the past 4.5 years, I've read more than the rest of my life combined. I guarantee you that. All right. Find mentors and find coaches on the subject. And it doesn't mean that you have to go up to somebody and ask them to be a mentor or coach. But once again, you study their life, read autobiographies, and follow people when you're around them, you feel like they help you to feel like the possibilities are endless, all right? And traveling also helps. Seeing how other people are living helps you to understand that there are other possibilities out there. And then the last thing is that once you have gotten the information, and we'll talk about this the next video. Once you have gotten the information means nothing if you don't take action on that information, right? So we're going to talk about that, about taking action on the information in the next video, in the video after that. So until that video comes out, this is Vaughn Edmead from AverageIsFailure.com. Remember, average is failure, success is intentional, and character is legendary. Let's go out and let's get it, y'all. Start 2016. Let's start this thing strong. Holla at me.